Hello everyone, today we'll be talking about a very important topic required by many of you, and we'll be talking about design of stairs, reinforced concrete stairs. We'll learn about different types of stairs, about the reinforcement, how to design which spans, and many other things. So first of all, let's learn about stairs. All stairs consist of horizontal part and inclined or slope part. This slope part is called flight, and the horizontal part is called landing. So we may have two landings and also two flights. Sometimes you have only one landing and one flight based on the type of the stair that you have. And if we take a close look here, so this flight consists of different steps. The rise of the step is called riser, and the width of the step is called the tread. And this, the thickness of the stair is called waist. And as we are talking about reinforced concrete stairs, so we should have also some reinforcement. We will have reinforcement in the longitudinal direction and reinforcement in the transverse direction. In general, we have main two different types of stairs. The first type is called the stairs spanning in the transverse direction. So the span of the stair will be in the transverse direction of the stair, where you may have this stair supported on a wall or two walls or beams. Or also the second type, it will be stairs spanning in the longitudinal direction, where this is the longitudinal direction of the stair, and this will be the span of the stair in this case. Let's learn about each type of these main categories of stair. We'll start by the first one, spanning in the transverse direction. And in this case, we have cantilever stairs, where you have the stair is supported only from one side to a reinforced concrete wall. So this will be like a fixed support. And in the other case, you may have it simply supported stair in the transverse direction, where the stair is supported into two walls, or a wall and beam is called the stringer beam, or it could be also two beams. But in all of these cases, the stairs are supported in the transverse direction of the stair. And for all of these types of the stairs, only one step will be designed in the transverse direction. So when we design this type of stairs, we take only one step and we design for one step. We get the reinforcement in the transverse direction, and then we repeat it for all other steps. And main stair reinforcement will be placed in the transverse direction, okay, in the same direction of the step. And minimum stair will be placed in the longitudinal direction. We should have also another reinforcement in the longitudinal direction, but will be minimum stair reinforcement. The main reinforcement will be in the transverse direction. Let's start by the first one, which is the cantilever stair. Cantilever stairs, each step is designed as a cantilever with a width B and mean effective depth equals to D. So when we design a step here, we take this as the dimension or the cross-section dimension of the step. Let's enlarge it here. It will be this shape. So when we design this step, we'll design as a section with a width equals to B, which is the width of the step. And the effective depth here will be from the top steel, which is the main steel in this case, to the center line of the step. So it is the average height between this one and that one. This will be the mean effective depth. So we can design, and then we get the reinforcement here. How to design that? We assume that the stair will be as a cantilever. So this step here is supported on the shear wall that we have it here as a fixed support, so it will be a cantilever. If we assume that we have a uniform load here with W and the span is L, so the moment here will be WL square over 2, and it will be also a negative moment, minus WL square over 2, and then you can design. Of course, if you have a handrail here, so you have to add additional load, and then you calculate the moment based on the uniform load and the additional load, concentrated load at the end, but it will be as a cantilever. And in this case, the main reinforcement will be placed in the top and anchored to the support. How we can do that? Let's say we take a section here in the stair, and this will be one step. So the main reinforcement, the moment is a negative moment, the tension is up, and therefore the main reinforcement should be also in the top direction. or the top surface of the step. And we can see here, this is the reinforcement and should be anchored to the shear wall to have a good fixation here of this cantilever. In the cross section, this will be the main reinforcement. Usually we use two steel bars at the top of the step to resist the negative moment that we have it here. Okay, how about the other reinforcement? A light mesh of reinforcement is placed on the in the bottom. So in this bottom here, we should have a mesh of reinforcement. We use minimum steel reinforcement in this case. How it will look here, it will be like that. You have longitudinal reinforcement and another transverse reinforcement with a light mesh. And in the section, it will look like that. Okay, so this is the first type of the stairs supported in the transverse direction, and this is the cantilever stair. Let's go to the second type of these stairs, which is simply supported stairs, also is still in the transverse direction. In this case, the stair is supported into two supports, not only in one side, so it is not cantilever anymore. So in this case, each step is usually designed as a simple beam, having a breadth B and an effective depth of D over 2. And let's see this one. So usually we design it like that. We take, this is the cross-section dimension of the step. The width of the step will be B, and the depth here will equal D capital over 2. So it will be half of this height. And in this case, the moment will be a positive moment. We design the step as assembly supported on this wall and this wall, or if they are two beams, it will be two beams. And therefore, if you have a load here equal W uniform load, the moment will be the famous one, which is WL square over 8. It will be a positive moment. It means the tension will be at the bottom. And therefore, the main reinforcement should be in the bottom side. The main reinforcement will be in the bottom side. Okay. And in this section here, you can see it will be this. Circles are the bottom steel reinforcement, and in the other direction, which is the longitudinal direction, we'll be using minimum steel reinforcement, will be both as distribution steel or minimum steel in the longitudinal direction. So these are the main two types of stairs supported in the transverse direction. The first one was cantilever, the second one was simply supported. Let's now go to the second big category of stairs, which are stairs spanning in the longitudinal direction. And also we can classify them into three different types. The first one, if the stair is spanning on two edge beams, you have a beam here at the end of the landing, another beam at the end of the landing. So this will call it spanning between edge beams. And the span in this case will be from the center line of the beam to the center line of the other beam. Also, you may have a stair like that where you have beams at the ends of the flight. So spanning between beams at the ends of the flight. And in this case, you have the flight is supported on this beam and that beam. And then you have the landing as a cantilever. And in this case, the span of the stair will be from the center line of the beam to the center line of the beam. Other parts here will work as a cantilever. And also the third category of this spanning bridges in the longitudinal direction will be spanning between landings. So the landing here and the landing here will work as a beam. And there is no clear beam as in the first two cases. So the landing will work as a beam, and also the landing here will work as a beam. And therefore the span in this case, we can consider it will be from the center line of the landing to the center line of the landing. So the middle part will take the load to the landing, and the landing will take it to the columns. Let's go to one by one with more details. The first, or like before going to more details, let's talk here about loads on all of these stairs spanning the longitudinal direction. When we calculate the dead load on the flight part, we should consider the length on the slope, okay? The slope length L dash. So when you calculate the dead load, we should multiply the load that we have it here with this inclined or slope length to get it as a resultant load. However, for the live load on the flight is calculated along the horizontal direction. Live load will go in the gravity direction. That will be in the horizontal direction. However, dead load will be calculated also in the gravity direction, but it will be calculated on the inclined or the slope length of the flight. The thickness of the waist is calculated as in one-way slabs. In this case, when we calculate the thickness of the stair itself, we use it as what we used to do in the one-way slabs. because it will be assumed as one-way slab from the support to support. Based on the span, you can calculate the thickness based on the span depth or basic span depth ratio. But also keep in mind that the span effective depth ratio may be increased by 15%, provided that the stair flight occupies at least 60% of the span. Here, we assume the span will be from some center line of the beam to the center line of the beam, but of course you have here a flight which is longer. So in this case, we can increase the effective span depth ratio by 15% to have a suitable thickness of the stair. Let's go to one by one. The first type of these stairs, the stairs spanning between edge beams, and the span in this case would be from the center line of the beam to the center line of the beam. How it will be the bending moment? This will be the shape of the bending moment. All will be a positive moment. It means the tension will be in the bottom side of the stair, no tension at the top. And therefore, if we want to see about reinforcement, the main reinforcement will be in the bottom side. And here we make it this way because we cannot make it continuous here because it will have a tension force and can have a crack. So therefore, in any case, when you have a tension in the bottom, you have to make like a scissor shape. The reinforcement here will extend to go to the compression side, and the reinforcement here will go extend to the compression side, so you'll not have any problem here. So this is the bottom steel reinforcement, which is the main steel in the longitudinal direction. In the transverse direction, we have to use also mesh of or a steel of minimum reinforcement. Distribution steel will be placed in the transverse direction above the main steel, which is in the longitudinal direction. The for that one, if we want to see more about the steel reinforcement, the bottom steel reinforcement, as we said, it will be in the bottom, as you can see here, and it will be like that. This is the steel reinforcement in the longitudinal direction. You have bottom steel going here and going up to the compression side, and you continue with the bottom steel also goes to the compression side. This is in the section, and this is the 3D shape. And in addition to this main reinforcement, you have distribution steel in the transverse direction. It will be as circles here, and you can see them. This will be the minimum steel in the other direction. So at the end, we have a mesh of steel reinforcement in the stair. The main steel will be in the longitudinal direction. The distribution steel will be in the transverse direction above the bottom steel, which is the main steel. The second type of stairs spanning the longitudinal direction will be the stair spanning between beams at the ends of the flights. And it is similar to the previous case, except in the case of the moment, we have the support at the end of the flight, another support, and we have two cantilever. Therefore, in this case, you have some negative moment above the support, and you have positive moment in the span. And therefore, you will have main steel reinforcement in the longitudinal direction in the bottom and also in the top at the tension side. So we have tension here at the bottom side, we have tension at the top side at the support. Therefore, we should have main steel reinforcement at the position of the tension. Therefore, the reinforcement here, this is the bottom steel as in the previous case. But in addition to that one, because we have tension force at the top and we have tension force at the top here above the beam, we should have also some steel reinforcement in the top layer to resist this tensile stresses or tensile forces at the top side above the supporting beams. Of course, in addition to the main reinforcement, we should have also minimum steel or distribution steel in the other direction as we did in the previous case. The third type of stairs spanning between landings, here we have the flight supported on the landing directly. And in this case, there is no beam. So the landing will work as a beam. In this case, the span will be from the center line of the landing to the center line of the landing. And will be similar to the first case when we have the beam was at the ends. But here we assume that the beam will be at the center line of the landing. And therefore, the reinforcement will be similar to the first case. We have bottom steel reinforcement, and we have also transverse steel. But you have to keep in mind in this case that the landing will be supporting higher loads and will have torsional stresses on the landing coming from this flight and the other flight going up, upward. And therefore, we should be careful about the design of the landing in this case. And usually it will have like some stirrups and we have top and bottom steel reinforcement to resist the torsional stresses and the loads coming from the flights. This will be the end of our video. If you like the video, please like, subscribe, and click the bell. And we'll see you in a coming video where we will go in details with designing of these different types of stair. Thank you for watching and looking forward to see you in a coming video. Goodbye.